Welcome to Picky Assist. In this video, we are going to explain how WhatsApp Web Automation works, and we will cover these topics: how it works, getting the demo access, connecting WhatsApp, and settings and configuration. WhatsApp Web Automation works with WhatsApp Personal and WhatsApp Business installed in an Android or an iOS device. We use your WhatsApp Web feature to automate the messages. So you have to connect your WhatsApp Web into our server by scanning the QR code. Please note, once the WhatsApp Web is connected in our server, you will not able to use WhatsApp in a browser or from desktop applications. However, you can continue use WhatsApp in your mobile phone as normal. WhatsApp Web Automation is a paid add-on, and by default it's not included in any of the packages. So you can request a 3 days trial from settings. Then from here you can request a trial by clicking this button and just fill the details. That's it. You just fill the details. You don't need to make any payment, but you can just fill the details and we will enable 3 days trial access. From the settings, WhatsApp Web Automation, and click on Activate WhatsApp Web. Now you can see the QR code. This needs to be scanned using the phone which need to connect to this project. Please don't take the screenshot of the QR code and share with someone else, as the QR code keep change in every 10 seconds. So if you would like to share the QR code, then we have a feature called QR code connecting URL. We can scroll down to see this here. So this is useful if the mobile is not with you or you are doing the setup for your customers. You can simply enable this feature, then share the URL with the user. Before sharing the URL with the customers, make sure the status is turned on. Now just copy this URL and try in a browser to see what happens. You can see the QR code is showing in a browser. Tell your customer to open the URL in a computer or any other phone and scan using the phone where WhatsApp is installed. So before scanning the QR code, we need to make sure that no other devices are connected to the WhatsApp Web. For doing this in an Android phone, just open WhatsApp, then from the top three dotted menu, select WhatsApp Web. And if you're seeing an option like this, that is last active today, this means the WhatsApp Web is connected in a computer or browser. So you need to log out from all devices, that is log out from all devices before we start doing. If you are not seeing this option, then you will be able to see that WhatsApp opens the camera and ready for scanning the QR code. For doing this in iPhones, open WhatsApp and from the bottom tap on the settings, then tap on WhatsApp Web or desktop. Now let's scan the QR code. Since my phone is connected to my computer, let me tap on logout from all devices. Okay, now you can see that the QR code is ready to scan, or the WhatsApp is ready to scan the QR code. So just click on tap activate WhatsApp Web. Now you can see the WhatsApp is paired and this window is closed without error. This means the WhatsApp is successfully paired. To sync with our server, it may take some time. Now you can see WhatsApp is connected to your Picky Assist project and this is the connected number. On clicking the disconnect button, the number will get released from Picky Assist servers. You can connect another number or can connect same number after some time. This is useful if you want to use your WhatsApp web or desktop application. Next is queued messages. Here it will show messages which are in queue. You can click on the refresh icon to get the latest queue count. For any reason, if you wish to delete queued messages, then you can use the clear queue button. This will clear all messages in the queue. Now, connected status. This helps you to identify whether the connection between your phone and our server is established or not. We have connection status, timeout, unpaired, no response. WA version, that means WhatsApp version. This is the WhatsApp web version number, just for reference. Next is connected date. This means on which date the number is connected to your project. The next is expiry date. This is the date when your add-on will expire. Incoming messages. This helps you to disable the incoming messages. Next is outgoing messages. This helps you to disable the outgoing messages. Once disabled, you will not be able to send messages out until it is enabled from here. Queue limit. This is one of the important value which helps you to queue the messages after it reaches certain count. For example, if you set the value to 10, then whenever you send more than 10 messages at a time, the system will automatically queue the messages and start processing as per the delay between the messages you configured. Delay between the messages. This is the value used to process messages from the queue. That is, if you set to 10 seconds, then the system will wait 10 seconds to send next message in the queue. The recommended delay between message is 10 seconds in order to avoid blocking of WhatsApp number. Sync messages from connected phone. When this is enabled, the system will track and sync all messages which are sent manually from the connected phone. Please note, only text messages will be synced. The next is send sync message out to webhooks. This is only for developers who would like to get the messages which are sent manually from the phone. Developers will get an additional variable direction. That is, direction is equal to 1. Download incoming video. If you would like to download the video files which are sent by the users, then please enable this. Enabling this will slow down the regular WhatsApp message sending and receiving speed of your server. Keep online. This feature helps you to get alert when the WhatsApp number is disconnected or difficult to connect with our server. To make this feature works more accurately, you need to enable the keep online status on. When you turn this on, your connected WhatsApp number will show always online to the users. And here, you can add email address to get disconnection alerts. You can add multiple email address as well here. Make sure you save the changes made by clicking the save button. We have two buttons more here, restart app and restart server. Don't get confused with the server restart and app restart. Both works differently. So let's understand the difference before using the commands. The restart app command will restart the app which is installed in your WhatsApp server. So this generally applicable to solve the issues as like a QR code not showing, connection timeout, low message sending speed, etc. The next is server restart. This is the dedicated server allocated to your project to connect WhatsApp numbers. Generally, server restart is not required until suggested by our support team. Server restart will take 5 to 10 minutes. So once the command is given, please wait for 10 minutes to perform next action. If you need any assistance, you can go through our help desk and navigate to setting up add-on, then click on setting up WhatsApp web. Here you can see detailed guide, instructions and frequently asked questions, etc. Still, if you have doubts or queries, then feel free to send an email to support@pikiassist.com. Thank you for watching this video.